is good, YouTube? Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis coming to you on a quick video. I wanted to let you guys know I got some new merchandise available, not just t-shirt anymore. I got different type of t-shirt, different type of shirts and logos that you can purchase on my spread shirt, and also hoodies now. We have expanded and added more to the channel and more merchandise for the brand. Thanks for supporting. It will be in the description and the links will be in the comment section below. Thanks for helping me and supporting the movement. Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis. I'm going to check out the video. What is good, YouTube? Quinn Wade Basketball Analysis coming to y'all with the video. I think you all expect it because it's the biggest news today, and I gotta give my perspective and my point of view, my analysis, because it's huge. The team that had them down 3-2 last year, a lot of people felt that if they had Chris Paul, they win that series. They have Chris Paul and Harden and a great bench, and they down 3-2 against the Warriors. This time, Houston had home court advantage last year. Home court advantage is going through Golden State this year. And if Houston do win at home, Game 7 will be in Golden State with Klay and Steph and Draymond, the original Big 3 in Golden State, having a chance to close it out and advance to the Western Conference Finals for the fourth, I believe, straight year, which is just absolutely ridiculous. Well, this would be the fifth year, I believe. That's hard to do. If you can go to the Western Conference Finals 5 straight years, it show you how magnificent and how great of a team you are. But I really had to think about this because I usually make videos earlier than this, but I really didn't know how to think about this because Kevin Durant has been so ridiculous this whole postseason. He just having an outer body experience. He has never really had a postseason run like this, where he just literally lighting you up for 30-plus every single game, attacking all different types of defense, taking all challengers and cutting all their heads off and going back and doing his thing on the court. He's passing the ball. He's rebounding. He's knocking out threes. He's being clutch. He's taking over. And we haven't seen Kevin Durant this aggressive ever as a Warriors outside of the NBA Finals. When he played against LeBron and averaged 35, he was aggressive. When he played last year, he was a little bit inefficient, but he was aggressive. But for Series 1 and Series 2, I never seen Kevin Durant obliterate and literally show and impose his will on the team. A lot of people felt like that's what they thought Russell Westbrook had the team because Kevin Durant was deferring. Now, I don't necessarily think it was Russell Westbrook's team. I just personally felt like Kevin Durant was doing what was best for Westbrook to get the best out of him. He's best when he attacks. He's best when he puts the defense at his heels. So he had to allow him to be himself for them to get the best out of Westbrook. And Steph Curry, he has deferred a lot. He hasn't been as aggressive. He hasn't took as many shots. He hasn't really took over that many games this whole postseason run. And Klay, he's been hot. He's been cold. He's been streaky. And usually Klay is one of those guys that's going to give you a guaranteed thing every single game, whether it's great defense or great shooting in defense, he's going to give you that. Draymond has been at his worst, not even voting as an all-star this season because of how much he has went down in value and how much his game has decimated. And on top of that, he hasn't been in the greatest shape. Now he looks like he's having fun. Now he looks like he's in those moments. He wants those moments. He wants those opportunities. He had huge blocks and steals, hit a big three yesterday, and it feels like Draymond is engaged. He's having a lot of energy, and he's really going out there doing this thing and causing havoc on both sides of the court. And then you have Iguodala, a guy that made some big shots already this postseason, is still one of the better perimeter defenders when it comes to one-on-one defense and help defense. He knows where to be. He knows how to guard his position. He knows how to guard certain players. And he doesn't foul that much unless it's a foul when they're coming at him. Other than that, he plays defense without contesting. But this is going to be a test. This is a Rockets team that was down 20, comes all the way back, takes the lead, and have a legitimate opportunity to win. And I heard a lot of people say this, and I'm going to refute them because I think they're right. This is the perfect time for the Rockets to get to the finals. I felt like last year was good for them because they was up 3-2, even though I did pick the Warriors to win that series. I feel like that was a great opportunity. They're a 60-win team. They got the MVP, and you got Chris Paul playing well in Utah, then he comes play well and close out games. In Golden State, he goes down out of nowhere. And next thing you know, they up game six and game seven, just can't close it out. And that's going to be the problem. Can the Rockets close out Golden State? Because even if they do win in Houston, can they really go against Oracle crowd with Steph Curry, knowing that he has to play his best basketball, knowing the big moment that he's in? You in Oracle, you have him and Clay and Draymond really locked in, really wanting to go, really wanting to beat this Rockets team. It's going to be tough to close them out, because I really had to take a lot of thought about that. Like, KD is gone, but he is the best player in the league right now, and it hurts to lose that person. But I just seen the reports that say if the Warriors do beat the Rockets, he can return back in the Western Conference Finals. Not only that, they also said DeMarcus Cousins, the further they go, the closer he can return back to this team. So they can get KD and DeMarcus if they can get out of this series. And the main reason why I say that is if they can get out of this series, they have an opportunity to still win it all. Because the fact that they can get DeMarcus and KD back while still having the same bench, which is intact right now with no major injuries. Because this team is already hard to beat. They're already up 3-2, and they closed out a game without KD and without DeMarcus. Just imagine if they get both of them back. The problem is the Rockets are just as good as the Warriors, if not better at this point. They can shoot threes, they can get hot, they can go cold, and they can blow you out in a second. Remember the Houston in game four, they laid it on the Warriors. Even though the Warriors came back, that just lets you know that this Rockets team, when they're going, when they're clicking, and when them jump shots and their defense is clicking, they are a tough team to beat. But you do have to beat the Warriors twice. And like I said, you have to beat them in Oracle at that. And you have Klay, Steph, and Draymond still there. They still have some solid players that could step up. But you're going to give more shots to Klay. You're going to give more shots to Steph. And they're going to have to step up. They've been okay this whole postseason run. Now they're in a situation where they have to play their best basketball, and they're needed to do it. And on top of that, you don't have the floor spacing. You can't really start Iguodala because he's not really a shooter. Draymond has been okay all postseason as a shooter. You don't really have that versatile big because DeMarcus is gone. Andrew Bogut is more of a screen setter. He's not really a scorer. Looney, not really a scorer. Jordan Bell is not really a scorer. Sean Livingston hasn't really been known for his offense all season. Where are you going to get the scoring? So the best thing for them to do is their defense. Allow yourself to slow down the Rockets. Make them take tough shots and contested shots. Get out in transition like they've been doing. Get some easy buckets. When the Rockets are lackadaisical, attack them early and get layups and spot up threes. Push the tempo. Get more shots. Because you're going to need Steph and Klay to get a lot of opportunities. The only bad part about it, you can trap them a lot. You can double team them a lot. And you can zone up on them a lot because they don't really have the proper outside shooting. Especially they don't have the explosiveness without KD that they used to have, because Steph is now 31. He's having an ankle problem. He still got a problem with his finger. Klay rolled his ankle. Plus, he hasn't really been shooting consistently, like I said, all postseason. This is one of the worst runs of Steph Curry's career in the playoffs. So, it ain't like you getting MVP Curry. You getting all-star, all-NBA Klay. You're getting both of them playing their worst basketball so far in this title run, but since this dynasty run. But I do believe that they can win one game. And this is going to sound even crazier. They only really got to win one quarter. If you go back and look at the series last year, like I said before, they was getting blew out in game six. They was getting blew out in game seven. But they got it right and knocked down shots and made plays in game six, in game seven, in the fourth quarter to close out that series when it mattered most. And they did it in Houston. So Steph and Klay and Draymond and the rest of the team, they can play great defense and stay in the game, just like they did in game five. And all they got to do is put together enough shots to send this team home. Houston cannot have a bad fourth quarter. They cannot have one turnover. They cannot make no mistakes because they're on the brink of elimination. So you would think that it put more pressure on Golden State. It put more pressure on Houston because they have a smaller margin of error because they are already at three losses. So I think that that's a lot of thing a lot of people are forgetting is that Golden State, we think they're done. We think they over, but they only really got to put together a couple great minutes, a great home ending stretch just to win this series. And they've been in every game against Houston this whole series. This has been a back and forth, whoever makes plays, whoever knocks down shots. This has been that whole series. Houston won some games they shouldn't have won. Golden State could have stole some games. They could have finished it in five, if I had to be real. But Houston can also be up in this series if they take care of the ball and knock down shots in the fourth quarter. So if I had to pick one or the other, Houston seems like they struggle getting quality shots. They seem like they struggle executing the executing. And I feel like it's going to be more focused on Steph and Klay. So it is going to be harder for them to get quality shots and opportunities because they have so many non-shooters that you can, you know, trap them and double team and get the ball out of their hands or force them into tougher shots. But we've done seen Steph and Klay go through that before and setting good screens, keeping the ball movement, doing backdoor cuts, keeping the defense honest and guessing and being unpredictable can really get you that 2, 3, 4, 5 points, those two back-to-back threes that can really seal this series. But I can say the same thing about the Rockets. The Rockets can get hot. The Rockets can rely on James Harden to create a foul or get a three or create from allow him to create a couple shots, and they can win by 3, 4, 5, or 6. Because that's what this series has really been. Whoever can get the shots to fall in the last 5 minutes, whoever can play great enough defense to get themselves more possessions, whether it's rebounding, whether it steals blocks, whether it's just pushing it faster in transition because Houston likes a showboat. I think the small little things is important. I heard people say that. And I think that when you look at the Warriors, they're capable of doing that. Houston won two games because of PJ Tucker doing it and other guys. I think the Warriors just have more urgency. They know that this could be it. They know that this is a huge chance for them to go back to the Western Conference Finals and win it all. I think that they're the champions. They've been through things that's tough. They was already down 3-2 last year, and they was able to finish off that series and sweep the LeBron Cavaliers. I think they've been through adversity. They know who they are. They know what they do. And if anything, they look more free and more fun when they all are on the same page and they all need each other. I feel like that's when you get the best Golden State, is when they all movement, they all communicating, and they all working together. I know that this KD style has worked because they won against the Clippers, and they literally was 2-2, and they had multiple opportunities to beat Houston and Houston, and they didn't. But you can still win this series because you only got to win a couple minutes in the fourth quarter, and that's how this series has been going. Can they knock down shots? Can they play defense? Can they play hard? Yeah, because they've been doing that this series. And they only got to do it for one more quarter or even a couple minutes in the fourth. And they can run away with this game. Houston takes a lot of tough shots. Houston makes a lot of mistakes. And if Golden State could capitalize off of them, they can get themselves a little cushion and just try to grind and ride it out like they did in game one and game two. And, you know, that's all you really need to do to get back to the Western Conference Finals. So I don't think it's over. At first, I thought it was over. At first, I thought they was done. But if they're trying to beat the Bucks or the Raptors, they're going to need KD. If they're trying to beat the Rockets gives you so many opportunities to capitalize off their mistakes, and it gives you a good chance of beating them. Just look at their fourth quarter. They turn the ball over. They make a lot of bad passes. They take a lot of tough shots, and they rely on James Harden dribble, taking a contested jumper, even though he can make them, even though it did help them win game three. They still down 3-2 for a reason, because Golden State has been overall the better team, and Golden State has overall played better than them in this series, and they should be up more than 3-2. But without KD, he's done for the rest of this Western this second round. They really got to dig deep, and they really just got to continue to trust and believe in each other, communicate, get quality shots, and let a lot of their pride and their ego go and just try to get the best shot they can and try to take advantage of that. I feel like they get a little bit excited, a little bit too trigger happy, and I feel like they get a little ahead of themselves. If they calm down and just make the right basketball plays and play together, they can still beat the Rockets. And if they beat the Rockets, I think they can beat Denver or Portland. We don't know who they'll play yet. But at the end of the day, KD is supposed to come back in the Western Conference Finals if they make it. I think that they can obviously be the favorites to beat Portland or Denver. And then it's just going to be tough trying to beat Toronto, Milwaukee, or Philly in the finals. But if DeMarcus Cousins and KD can come back, I think they still should be the favorites. And they still got a legitimate chance of winning this. Only problem is Houston is not going to be easy. Houston going to be prepared. And Houston know that they backs against the wall. And they see they like sharks that see blood. They ready to attack. They ready to go. And they really can steal this and go far. If Houston beats Golden State, they got as good as a chance as anybody to win it all. That's how great of a team they are. It's just about taking advantage of that and seeing this weakness, taking care of business at home, and going out there trying to finish and slit their throat in game 7, which is going to be tough at Oracle. But then again, if you want to be a champion, you want to be the team at the top of the hill at the end, these are things you're going to have to go through. These are things that go in your favor. You have to go out there, play like a championship team, execute, play defensively, play together, knock down shots, and literally go out there and fight like it's your last game, which it is, because if they lose one quarter, one game, they done. And at the end of the day, we're going to see what type of Rockets is it. Is they going to be opportunists, or are they going to play it safe, or are they going to go out there trying to go out there and win it all? Because if they win this series, they got just as good a chance as everybody else left in the playoffs to win it all. And to me, that's why I think it should be fun for game 6. Who wants it more, who plays harder, and who really has that inner deepness that they can pull out and get it done. Let me know, is Golden State done? Do you think they can still win? Do you think that if the Rockets are better, which they are in this kind of weird way, but can they play together? Can they play like a championship team, which we haven't seen them do yet in the postseason? And if that's the question, then Golden State should be able to close it out. If not, the Rockets missed on a hell of an opportunity to win it all this year. They blew it last year. They got another opportunity this year. They should feel that way. They should be thinking that way. And then it's time to go out there and get it done. Check out my website, analysisplayground.com. Link will be in the description, comment section below. Check out my Facebook page, analysisplayground.com. Link will be in the description, comment section below. Like on Facebook. Thanks for everybody that likes on Facebook. Thanks for everybody that likes the videos and comment to keep it active. I read every comment and I try to respond to the ones that make sense. Also, thanks for everybody buying merchandise. I actually have my spread shirt down in the description comment section below. And I also have it on my Facebook page, so you can message me on Facebook or get it off spread shirt and I can get you some merchandise. Thanks for everybody that supports the brand and this dream of mine. Also, I do discussions, free agency, trade deadline breakdowns, tributes, and rookie breakdowns. I cover summer league. I cover the draft. Also, I do all videos NBA, so you love NBA, you love basketball. I make videos every day. I have different type of content, and I do go hard on this. So if you love basketball, subscribe, check out my older videos, check out my playlists on my channel, and become part of the family. This is fun. I really enjoy making these videos. I love making these videos, and I love the fact that you guys continue to watch, continue to support. And at the end of the day, all I can do is say thank y'all. But let me know, is Houston, this is their golden opportunity, or will it be fool's gold and they still find a way to lose it to Golden State? Or is KD the new the face of the league? Is he the new face of the Golden State Warriors? Is it live and die by KD and they done? Or can we see some old Stephen Clay, the killers, that can blow you out, that can go out there and get and do whatever they want to do on the court and dance about it? It is good to see them back. It is good to see them in this situation because we want to see how they're going to handle it. But they are champions. They had situations like this before, and they was able to get through them. This is just another chance to show that we deserve the three-peat, and we're going to get it done because we're the best team in the NBA still, regardless of record.